A very warm welcome to you as joining us on today's episode of Tax Matters. My name is Olumo Iwa Matuloko. How's your week been and how is business going? Alternative dispute resolution and arbitration have now become part and parcel of the judicial system all over the world. And so it is with taxation. The intention is to ensure that parties to agreements have avenues beyond the regular court system to resolve disputes and come to an amicable settlement. Today, our guest is the Coordinating Secretary of the Tax Appeal Tribunal in Nigeria, TAT for short, in the person of Malam Yahaya Manga. He will be talking to us about the role of the Tax Appeal Tribunal as an alternative dispute resolution platform in the Nigerian tax system. Malam Yahaya Manga, you're welcome to Tax Matters.
Thank you so much. Yes,
as you heard in our introduction, we are looking at the different ways in which the taxpayer, even the tax collector, can resolve matters without necessarily going ab initio through the judicial process. You are in charge of the Tax Appeal Tribunal. But let's start this way. For the benefit of our viewers, what are the avenues available to the tax collector or even to the taxpayer in resolving disputes?
Thank you, Muyiwa. There are basically three avenues that aims at resolving tax disputes. The first one is a taxpayer can go by way of protest to the tax authorities, be it the Federal Inland Revenue Service or the state's boards of inland revenue. Number two is by way of appeal to the Tax Appeal Tribunal. And number three is having recourse to the regular courts. The regular courts here is the Federal High Court, and probably where issues are not resolved, a taxpayer or the tax authorities can appeal by way of going to the Court of Appeal or the Supreme Court, as the case may be. In any case, this process, like I started saying, is in sequence. The protest first, then the appeal to the Tax Appeal Tribunal, then the regular courts. You cannot have access to the regular courts without exhausting the first two mechanisms.
Okay, so I come to the Tax Appeal Tribunal if I've not been given justice at the level of the tax authority, be it FRS or the State Board of Internal Revenue. Okay, so at what time was the Tax Appeal Tribunal established? What is the origin of the TAT?
You see, subsequent to the establishment of the Federal Inland Revenue Service Act 2007, yes, the appeal process was such that taxpayers could have recourse to either the VAT tribunals or the body of appeal commissioners. These were in place, and with the coming of the Federal Inland Service Establishment Act 2007, these two bodies were collapsed into the Tax Appeal Tribunal. A Tax Appeal Tribunal was created. And the creation is by way of Section 59(1) of the Act.
What is the composition of the Tax Appeal Tribunal? Tax Appeal Tribunal, it's not a court now. Is it a judge that sits atop the tribunal, or what is the composition of the Tax Appeal Tribunal?
The composition is such that it involves legal practitioners, tax practitioners, and the accountants. This composition, to me, I feel is deliberate. It provides the necessary expertise in dealing with tax issues.
So where is the TAT located?
Currently, TAT is located in 8 zones. Abuja, Lagos, Southwest, which is in Ibadan, the South South, which is in Benin, the Southeast, which is in Enugu, the North Central, which is in Jos, the Northeast, which is in Bauchi, and the Northwest, which is in Kaduna, with a coordinating secretariat in Abuja that serves as a liaison for all the tribunals in the country.
No. Okay. Who can go to the tax appeal tribunal? Is it the taxpayer or the tax authority? Who do you attend to?
Either of the two can go. The tax authorities can approach the tribunal, and the taxpayer can equally approach the tribunal. But the beauty of it is that you don't require the services of a lawyer to approach the tribunal, because the tribunal rules are made so user-friendly, so flexible, that you can approach the tribunal and seek redress as a taxpayer.
Which ones have preponderance between the tax authorities at state and federal level and taxpayers? From the records available to you, which ones have come more than the other?
As far as we are concerned, from the records available before us, the cases are more like instituted by the taxpayers of recent, much more than the tax authorities.
Mm. And do the tax authorities readily agree to your rulings?
Both parties agree to the judgments, but where you don't agree, the law says you can now approach the regular courts and seek further justice on your complaint.
But what have you found? Have you found people respecting the TAT and then settling amicably?
Yes, people do settle amicably, agree as to the terms of settlement. But like I said, it is your case. Probably you may not welcome the decisions of the tribunal, and you have the right to go ahead to appeal against such decisions.
So there is nothing you can do. I can't believe this. Last year I let it go. This year my tax assessment is even worse. They keep doing this because they know there is no one we can complain to.
But there is.
Really?
Yes. You can go to the Tax Appeal Tribunal.
Tax Appeal Tribunal?
Yes.
The Tax Appeal Tribunal is established to resolve all tax disputes between taxpayers and the Revenue Authority. So when your tax disputes are not resolved to your satisfaction, the Tax Appeal Tribunal is there to help. You can visit any of our offices nationwide or call us on 0987-611-70 or email info@tat.gov.ng for support. Tax Appeal Tribunal, building confidence in Nigeria's tax system.
It's a new dawn in Nigeria, and the mantra is change. The wind of change is blowing all over Nigeria and beckons to you. One sure way to respond is to perform your civic duty, pay your tax. With taxes, government generates revenue to fulfill its electoral promises, and your regular power supply provide good security, standard education, medical care, true total change. Individuals and corporations enjoy specific benefits, rights and privileges for paying taxes and avoid the consequences and penalties of not paying. Oil revenue is no longer sufficient to bring desired change, but your tax can. It pays to pay your tax. A message from the Federal Inland Revenue Service.
Welcome back. The program is still Tax Matters, and we are looking at the Tax Appeal Tribunal, an alternative dispute resolution mechanism put in place for the comfort of the taxpayer, and I dare say the tax collector, because the Tax Appeal Tribunal provides a platform for parties to any dispute regarding taxation to resolve the issues amicably. And our guest is the coordinating secretary of the Tax Appeal Tribunal. The coordinating secretary, sir, what are the steps that somebody who wants to approach the tax appeal tribunal, what are the steps that he has to take? What is the process for making use of the platform?
The process is simple and straightforward. An aggrieved party or appellant, depending on the way you want to call him, may file an appeal at any of the tribunals as long as the course of action emanates from that zone he is filing the appeal.
Okay.
Yeah. The law provides that the course of action, now the issue you are complaining about, should be filed within 30 days of its happening, yes. But this rule is not like casted on an iron, yes. Where you are filing this case beyond 30 days, you approach the tribunal and make your case. The tribunal can go ahead and accept it, and accept your case and listen to you. The beauty of everything is that anybody can file an appeal before the tribunal, and he may choose to represent himself.
How much do I pay? What does it cost?
Next to nothing.
What do you mean by next to nothing?
A token fee will be paid. In any case, your case will be assessed based on the amount of money involved in the case. You'll be assessed and you now pay the filing fee. It's called filing fee.
On the average, how long does it take to resolve a matter at the tax appeal tribunal?
You see, when we came on board, the tribunal chose to do like a case flow manual. And each case is expected to last from filing to disposal 180 days.
Okay, that's 6 months.
Yes, that is the average. Okay. It could be less. But where it is more than that, we always prevail on the tribunals to still work within that time frame of the 180 days.
Are the tribunals always in session? Are they always sitting?
The tribunal sits at least once in the month. A sitting session could be for 3 days or 5 days, depending on the number of cases before it.
Have you found instances where, because of these 180 days and all that, that a case is still pending at the tax appeal tribunal and the tax man is eager to get his money? Have you had instances where the tax authorities have disobeyed the tribunal to chase the tax taxpayer?
No. You should remember the fact that the tax appeal tribunal is a creation of the statute. The statute now in question is the Federal Inland Revenue Services Establishment Act. So we don't expect a taxman to do the contrary.
You have not had them doing the contrary. I'm putting you on the spot.
Thank you very much.
Okay, you have spoken so glowingly. So we assume that it's been a smooth run,
yeah,
so to say, for the tax appeal tribunal. What would you consider to be the achievements of the tribunal in the last 7-8 years?
Mr. Muiwa, honestly, achievements of the tribunal or any statutory body established like this is basically relative. You see, the achievements of the tribunal should not be viewed from the tax revenue of the government, but should be seen holistically from its impact on the tax system. Specifically, let me take you through some of them. One, the most important is the acceptance of the appeal process in Nigeria. You see, a total number of 122 appeals were inherited from the defunct Board of Appeal Commissioners and the VAT tribunals. This was as at when we came in 2010. From 2010 to 31st July 2015, 404 new appeals were filed, while 336 appeals were concluded within those years. 205 appeals are pending across the zones as at today. The number of new cases and the number of cases determined is quite encouraging. Number two, the Tax Appeal Tribunal has actually helped to build taxpayer confidence in the tax system, as taxpayers are aware that dispute with the tax authorities can be dispassionately resolved through an independent dispute resolution mechanism. You see, most of the time, delays in resolving disputes in the tax system can be a major clog in the wheel of tax administration. But the TAT has facilitated and quickened this process. This has invariably reduced the tax appeal dispute process and cost of litigations on the taxpayer and the tax administration. Finally, tax revenues that could have been trapped in a prolonged litigation process are freed through an effective tax appeal process in the TAT. You see, these are some of the achievements of the tribunal, if you are looking at it from the holistic point of view.
And we really want to congratulate you. And let me say that we agree that these things are not to be looked at merely in naira and kobo terms. It's about building the confidence of the taxpaying public in the tax system. Another big one, sir. We've had instances where the tax authorities enforce, they go on enforcement. That is to say, they visit taxpayers' premises, collect cartels and all that. We call it enforcement. We've shown that on this program. Are we to conclude that in those instances, the Tax Appeal Tribunal has been approached and the case is final and conclusive?
No, you find out that there are so many aspects of enforcement. It could be enforcement from the decision of a court. It could be enforcement from the decisions of the tribunal where the taxpayer refuses to appeal against and the time has lapsed. Yes. But both enforcements and the appeal process are still the creation of the statute.
Yeah. We are coasting home. What is your advice to our viewers, to the taxpayer out there?
On a final note, I would want to say that we solicit the support of the general public and other relevant stakeholders to assist us deliver on the objectives of the establishment of the Tax Appeal Tribunal. For us at the TAT, TAT is the short form for the Tax Appeal Tribunal, we shall strive to be a leading tax dispute resolution center of international repute. by providing parties a flexible and efficient dispute resolution mechanism that will promote public confidence and voluntary compliance with tax laws.
So you advise anybody who has exhausted the internal mechanisms available to approach the tax appeal tribunal?
To approach the tax tribunal.
Do you have any links with similar bodies beyond the shores of Nigeria?
Yes, of course. With time and our coming on board, we have contact with a lot of other jurisdictions in the world, and we are relating with them very well, and we will continue to relate with them to enable us provide better services to the taxpaying community in Nigeria.
Talking about the locations of the TAT, have you found the 8 locations sufficient? We see they're a bit far flung. Okay, you have one in Bauchi, you have one in Jos, you have one in Kaduna, Benin, Ibadan, Lagos. Are you planning to establish more centers, or you are bound by law to retain 8?
You see, for now, the law provides for the 8 locations. And with time, where the exigencies of the work permit, we can open up. The laws can be looked into with a view of allowing us open up other locations.
The cases that were inherited by the TAT from the Body of Appeal Commissioners and the Value-Added Tax Tribunal, the VAT Tribunal, have you resolved them?
Yeah, these cases have been resolved. They are part of the over 300 cases I told you have been resolved.
We thank you very much for your time, sir, and we wish the TAT the best of luck. We congratulate you on your modest achievements and wish you the best of luck.
Thank you very much, Mubi. I'm looking forward to you paying your tax or meeting you at the tribunal.
We pay our taxes. We assure you that we won't have any cause to complain because we are happy.
Pay as at when due.